One day my mom came back and saw a friend of mine braiding my hair. My mom beat me so much, took a blade and scraped out my hair, completely bald, and I had school the very next day.
It should be illegal. Like, a lot of them need to be arrested because it just doesn't make any sense. And they don't realize that when they're doing this, they are literally putting trauma in that child's life that will literally follow them into their adulthood.
Stop blaming them. You have a chance to forgive your dad. Your dad is still alive. And you're busy not talking to him? Guess what? My father died when I was 4.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Let's watch this video. It's about a Nigerian lady crying because of what the mom did to her. Let's watch.
You guys, I've been crying since I woke up this morning. I'm sorry, I need a minute. Okay, so I woke up this morning to a very heated argument with my African Nigerian mother about the trauma that she put me through. About the trauma that she and my dad put me through. How they used to beat the shit out of me as kids. And I'm going to the gym right now because I need to take all this energy off. I already used my Florida water this morning, but I'm so traumatized because they fucked my life up. They treated me like an adult when I was a child. I took care of my siblings. I took them to school. I baited them. I raised my siblings as of like 10 years old, because as of 9 years old, I was back home. I was taking them to school. I was feeding them. And now I was trying to tell her the things that she did to me and how she ruined my life. How I can't even have a regular relationship with anybody. Like, my relationship is fucked up because my trauma keeps popping up in there and I keep projecting it on them and it just fucked them up. And I was trying to talk to her today because she did the same thing to my sister. And I told my mother, I said, Mom, the way you're going about this thing, you're gonna lose this girl. She's gonna leave the house. And the same shit she did to me when I left home at 17, you're gonna do it to this girl. And she was like, well, if I didn't do that to you when you were a child, are you gonna be the way you are right now? I was like, Mom, are you serious right now? You traumatized me. You fucked up my life. My dad used to beat me. Like, he wouldn't stop beating me until there was blood on my body. Like, until he saw that I was bleeding. And now she wants me to call him and talk to him and kiki with him. And I'm telling her you can't be positive and she's asking me to forgive. I have forgiven, but I would never forget because you fucking hurt me. And now I have to go to...
That's really terrible. The blood part is really, really terrible. But one thing I'm going to say is this. In African home, in Nigeria to be specific, if you are the first child or you have other siblings behind you and your parents are the working class type, they are hardly home, you'll be forced to raise your siblings yourself. You have to shower them, feed them, even cook for everyone to eat. It's common, it's norm in African homes, but I'm not saying that's the best thing to do. I'm not saying it's good, but we are traditional people. We have our own culture. It's part of the culture, I think so. Maybe I'm wrong. If I'm wrong, correct me in the comment section. The part that is off for me, the part I don't agree with, is the beating part. You beat your child until you see blood. Like, it doesn't make sense. Is that person not supposed to be your child? Is that person not supposed to be your blood? Why would you subject your child to such pain and trauma? That part, I'm not in support. In my own family, my parents hardly beat us. I can't count the number of times that happened, and It wasn't even, they can't beat you to have blood, no. You just have to have cane and then give you 5 strokes and all that. You do anything bad, but it wasn't common in my family. The most my mom would do is nag you to death. I mean, like, nag you. Something that happened like 3 days ago, she would keep talking about it. Mommy, it's okay. This just happened 3 days ago. Why are you still talking about this? That's the most we got. Before they would even think about beating, you must have done something horrible. Really, really horrible. And they feel like, okay, the only way they can deal with this is beating you. Other than that, no. You think you've heard the worst of it? Let's watch the next video.
And my dad put me through how they used to beat the shit out of me.
Okay, I'm going to start off by being sympathetic because she's obviously crying in the video. I'm sorry that you're hurt. I'm sorry, you know, you feel like you went through a lot. But come on. Come on. As Africans, Nigerians specifically, we all went through that. We all did. We all did. Almost every single Nigerian, their parents beat them till blood came out. And you know what? I will be thankful if that was all my mom did to me. I'll be thankful if, you know what, all my mom did was beat me till blood came out. Let me tell you the tip of the iceberg. One day, I cut onions big. That's all I did. That was all the wrongs that I did. I cut big onions. My mom took pounded yam stick. Pounding yam. It's a big stick. It's called akodo. Africans, you know what I'm talking about. Akodo, she pounded me in the kitchen. One day my mom came back and saw a friend of mine braiding my hair. My mom beat me so much, took a blade and scraped out my hair completely bald, and I had school the very next day. My mom beat me so much one day because I stopped by at a friend's house and she came back before me. She beat me so much one day, I went to Air Force, right? People, my neighbors, thought it was the soldiers at my school that did that to me. I had very big marks all over my body. And it's not no bring out your hand. Mom will flog you everywhere and she'll flog you when you're naked. My mom has put pepper, atarodo pepper, on a cane and stuck it in vagina. So please, please. That is the way we are raised. Is it made us who we are. It made us the strong, resilient, intelligent people that we are. So stop blaming your parents and take responsibility for your life. You're a grown up. You're a grown up. Take responsibility for your life. If you are fucking up your relationships, you are the one fucking up your relationships. It has nothing to do with your parents. Stop blaming them. You have a chance to forgive your dad. Your dad is still alive. And you're busy not talking to him. Guess what? My father died when I was 4. I would give anything to have a moment with that man. My mom has done so much to me and so has other African parents. Go get yourself together, please. What's it? Oginide. Get yourself together. And stop blaming your parents. What rubbish.
No, I don't agree with this person's point. No, you don't tell people how to feel. Everyone experiences life different and people react to life differently, because you could take the pain, you could take the beating from your parents, you could take all the treatment from your parents. It does not necessarily mean that the next person should take it. I know we have this particular mentality in Nigeria, because you could take something bad that happened to you and then you see the next person complaining about it, how they were not able to handle it. You'd be like, oh, you're weak, oh, you're this, oh, why would you complain, oh, it happened to me and I took it, why can't you take it, why are you complaining? It's not supposed to be that way. We should respect people's feelings regardless of how we ourselves reacted to it. I don't agree with what that lady said. Trauma is trauma. Honestly, what is traumatizing your neighbor might not be traumatizing you, because you took it in does not necessarily mean the next person has to take it in. What she's saying is valid, but what the other lady said, what the first person said is valid. What the other person said, I don't agree with her. Why would your mom treat you like you're a slave? Why would your mom treat you like she is not your mom? And you're cool with that? It's up to you. It's your own business. So don't think because you could take it, next thing you should take it. I don't agree. Let's see what other people are saying.
about the trauma that she put me through.
Unfortunately, we cannot choose the mothers that we're born to. But what we can choose is who we give our energy to. Let her go. Sometimes trying to talk to someone who is just does not want to listen is not going to work. Sometimes you just need to just cut them off and let it be. Even if it is your mom. Because no one just gets to hurt you. You deserve respect and you deserve to be heard. So if she does not want to listen, she does not deserve your time. You keep succeeding. You keep pushing forward. Do it for yourself. Because you deserve to be happy. So go. Be happy. Bye.
Okay. I love this one. I love this one. Let's hear the next one.
A very heated argument with my African Nigerian mother.
I will always say this one thing. Whenever a parent puts their hands on their child in order to punish them or correct them, it's not necessarily because that child did anything that was that severe. It's simply because that parent is trying to release anger. There are a lot of parents out there who harbor a lot of anger and frustration in them, and they literally use their kids as punching bags in order to release that anger. Specifically in the Black community, like West Africans, African Americans, Caribbeans. And this is coming from somebody who's also Nigerian and who grew up in a West African household. The methods that Nigerians use in order to punish their kids, it should be illegal. Like, a lot of them need to be arrested because it just doesn't make any sense. And they don't realize that when they're doing this, they are literally putting trauma in that child's life that will literally follow them into their adulthood. And then a lot of them are confused why their kids in their 20s don't call them back or don't ever check up on them. It's simply because of how you treated them as kids. Like I always say, me personally, I don't want children. However, I would never understand putting my hand on a kid in order to correct them or to punish them. But yeah, go watch your video. Like, it's really sad that stuff like this, especially today in 2023, it still goes on. Like, I feel like something needs to be done.
Argument with my African Nigerian mother about,
let me just say to this young lady that I am sorry that this happened to you, but your life is not over as you continue to go through the process of healing, because you are aware that is the first step. And as you unpack what you have experienced and you heal the parts of you and you accept that you will not get what you need from your mother or your father, the rest of your life will be beautiful. Trust me when I say that to you, because I understand to a degree, not fully. I'm obviously not Nigerian and I don't know the culture there. But as an African American woman who has dealt with the mother wound, who has healed from the mother wound, and who has recently just had an experience with her mother, to where it has caused me to realize that the boundaries that I had set now need to be firmer, because you're not going to project your trauma, speaking of my mother, your issues, your demons, all of that onto me or to my children. And the way in which I went about this was I had to get my behind in therapy. I had to unpack the various layers of gaslighting that happened to me as a child. Had to unpack the way that me taking care of my maternal dying grandmother at the age of 8 impacted how I became a caregiver for everyone else and not myself. I had to unpack the fact that I became so hyper independent that I wouldn't even allow my vulnerability or my need for help to come into play until I didn't have any other options. So for my people that are dealing with the mother womb, any parental womb, mother womb or father womb, do yourself the best thing that you can do. Get into therapy. Get into therapy. Rally around some people and community that will hold you up in this process, because it's not easy. When you decide that you want to detach yourself from something that is toxic,
especially it being a parental figure, there are going to be a lot of naysayers and there's going to be a lot of chatter around your decision to do that. But remember why you're doing that. And it's number one, to protect your peace and your sanity and sanctity. Y'all know what I'm saying. And if you have children, for your children to see firsthand what it looks like to operate and to maintain healthy boundaries, not from a place of anger, not from a place of fear, from a place of peace and protecting that peace at all costs.
True. So at this point, she has to decide if she's going to keep being in contact with her parents or she's going to detach. Because from her conversation, I'm making reference to the first speaker, from a conversation, she sounds so traumatized, extremely traumatized, and she felt having the conversation with her mom would give her the closure she's looking for. Unfortunately, her mom couldn't see reasons with her. And I think, like I said, it's a cultural something. I think it's related, kind of culturally related. I don't know how to explain it, but this is how I feel, because the reason why I'm saying it's culturally related is because it's common amongst the Blacks, it's common in Nigeria. Like, every child or almost every household would tell you similar stories when it comes to African parents. So it's like, I think it's a tradition and culture, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So if you feel traumatized, I don't know how it was for you in your family. Mine wasn't this way. No, God wouldn't let that happen. Mine wasn't this way. But if you find yourself in this situation and you feel like you need to heal, I think going for therapy and detaching is also a good way to deal with this. Detach with the toxic parents and then seek therapy. This is my own little advice. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. What do you think about the second person that replied and said, get used to it, this is an African home, this is how it's been done, everyone has experienced it, so why would you come online and cry about that? What do you think about that person's reply? For me, that doesn't make sense. I already spoke about it. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.